Hello everybody and welcome back to another tutorial video. Now in today's video I'm going to be showing you guys another method that you can use to homebrew your Nintendo Wii console. Now if you guys don't know, a couple of years ago I made a tutorial video showcasing the popular letter bomb method that is used and that has been used for many years to homebrew the Nintendo Wii. And after seeing many comments on that video saying that, you know, this is great, but I don't have an SD card, or I don't have a way of copying files over to an SD card for my computer. Is there any other way that I can homebrew my Nintendo Wii? Now, there was another method released after the homebrew or the letter bomb method that allow you to homebrew your Wii using the internet channel. It was called Flash Hacks, and what you would do is go to a website on the internet channel. I personally was never able to get that method to work, and plus, if you don't have the internet channel installed on your Wii, you can't do it because the Wii Shop channel has been shut down. But this new method that I'm going to show you today is not only way easier than both of those methods, but it also doesn't require any, you know, prerequisites. You don't need to have an SD card or a channel installed. The only thing that you need to get your Wii homebrewed using this method is an internet connection. That's it. If you can connect your Wii to the internet, you can homebrew it right out of the box. And I'm going to be showing you just how easy it is in this video tutorial right here. So all you want to do is, from your Wii's home screen or your Wii menu, go to the Wii options in the bottom left corner of the screen. Then what you want to do is go to the Wii settings option on the right here, and you want to first, before you do anything, verify what version that your system is running. Now it needs to be 4.3. Now the letter at the end here, it'll be either a U, an E, a J, or a K, and that just corresponds to which region that your Wii was manufactured to work in. So if you were in Europe, for example, and you had a European Wii console, it would be a 4.3E instead of a U. It's a U because I'm in the US. So what you want to do is, if you have anything other than 4.3, you want to go to the very last page of your system menu and perform a Wii system update. Don't format it, but perform a Wii system update. Once you've done that, you want to come back to your Wii settings screen here and go over to the second page where you see the internet options right here. You want to go into that. And what you want to do is, if you don't already have your Wii connected to the internet, go to connection settings and go to connection 1. You can use any one of these, but we're going to go into connection 1. And there should be an option here to actually set up and, you know, get your Wii either connected wirelessly or wired to your home network. Once you've done that, you want to go into the connection that you're currently using. So for me, that's connection 1 right here, and go down to the third option, which is change settings. And what you want to do is press the plus button on your Wii remote to go over a couple of pages, and what you're looking for is the DNS settings. So I think it's about 2 or 3 pages over. Now you want to be careful because the IP address, the auto obtain IP address, and the auto obtain DNS look very similar. You want to make sure that you're on the auto obtain DNS setting and not the IP address. You do not want to modify the IP address. You want to go over to the DNS address and modify that. What you want to do here is select no, we don't want to auto obtain it, and you want to click on advanced settings. And what you're basically want to do here is set up a custom primary and secondary DNS that allow this exploit to work. So I'm going to show you what you have to actually put in here. Go to the primary DNS setting. So it should be 97.74.103.14. Put this in here and select OK. Then go to the secondary DNS. And for the secondary DNS, you want to put in 173.201.71.14. Once you have that put in, you want to press OK, and you want to confirm these two numbers right here because it's imperative that you get both of these numbers exactly correct as I have them here. If you don't, well, this exploit's not going to work. Once you have both these in here, you just want to press the confirm button here, and you want to save the settings. Now, the Wii is going to ask you to perform a connection test. So go ahead and press OK. And this can take a while, but what the Wii is going to do is just basically test this connection, see if it can actually reach out to the internet. And if this doesn't work, you're going to have to reconfigure those settings and make sure that your Wii is able to actually connect to the internet through your home network. So you may have to modify some settings there if you can't get this to work. But this can take a while. It can take longer than you think because the Wii is just, you know, very slow at this for whatever reason. But once it tests this connection, it'll come up with a screen asking you to perform a system update. And I'm going to show you what you should do once that screen appears. Alright, so if you've done everything right, you should see this screen right here that says the connection test was successful, perform a Wii system update now. You want to press no, okay? Now what you want to do is go back out of your connection settings a couple of pages. So hit back and then hit back again. So you're back at the internet options menu here. Now what you want to do is select user agreements, okay? And you want to press yes right here. And what this is going to do is load the Wii EULA, and it's actually through this that this exploit is able to work. So we're going to press next here, and it's going to connect to the internet. And basically what this EULA normally does is it at this point reaches out and downloads the most recent EULA from Nintendo. But when you change those DNS settings, what it will do is display this in place of the EULA. Now, as far as I know, this is actually made by the same author who created FlashHacks, which I mentioned at the beginning of the video, which was the internet channel method. So this is actually made by him, but it's just made much easier now because if you don't have the internet channel on your Wii, you can't use FlashHacks. And in my case, I couldn't even get FlashHacks to work. I tried it multiple times. The Wii kept freezing and locking up, and it wasn't working. This method here I've had much more success with. Now, as it says, if your Wii remote stops responding, so if it just totally freezes and you cannot move the Wii cursor around, it's failed and you have to restart your system and try this whole method again. I have not had to do this in my previous, before that I actually started recording, actually doing this method. It did work for me on the first try, so maybe I just got lucky. You guys might have to try this a couple of times, I don't know, but I can say that this is much easier. This is the easiest method I've ever used to homebrew my Nintendo Wii console. Now, it does take about 1 to 2 minutes to actually do anything, and you want to make sure that you don't press the I accept or the I don't accept. You want to keep it on this screen. If you press I accept, it will go back to the Wii menu, and you'll have to come in to do this again. But you see that this is a good sign right here. It has started actually loading the exploit. Now you'll see that it actually tries to find the boot.elf file on the SD card, and when it doesn't, it just tries to download it over the network. So that's what's so great about this, is that you don't even need to have a SD card, as I said. It's just going to download everything over the network. Now it will sit on this screen for a minute. You'll see that the text on my TV here has actually gone past the actual display, so there's that bottom line of text that I can't see. But when you see this, it might look like something is wrong, but this is actually a very good sign, because this next screen here might look very familiar to any of you guys who have homebrewed your Wii before. This is the HackMii Installer. It has downloaded successfully without me having to copy any files over to my Wii manually from my computer. And we're just going to sit on this screen and wait for the option to press 1 to continue to appear. And yes, it does give you this warning that if you paid for this software, if you followed somebody else's guide and they charged you money to download the software, you have been scammed. So you want to demand your money back, as it says. We're just going to go ahead and press 1. And here we are in the HackMii Installer. So we're going to press A to continue. Now, I already have the Homebrew channel installed, as you probably saw from the beginning of this video. But what you would do is just use the up D-pad button to go up to install the Homebrew channel. And you would go through that process. You just have to press install and then yes, and it will install the Homebrew channel. And you'll be back at this screen here. So you can also use this method if you already have the channel installed to uninstall and basically un-homebrew your Wii. You can also install BootMe if you want. I don't have this installed, but the option is there for you. And once you're done with this, you just have to press exit and it will launch into the Homebrew channel, as you can see right here. So here is my Homebrew channel. You can see that I have a USB Loader GX installed. If you want to see a tutorial on how to basically run your Wii games off of a USB hard drive, check out my tutorial on USB Loader GX. It'll be up at the top right of your screen right now. But there you have it, guys. We're just going to press the home key to exit out to the system menu. That is how easy it is now to homebrew your Wii. You now don't have to download anything, as I said before. This is the easiest method that I've ever seen. And I believe that this method will be around for years to come, because the Wii is not going to be updated. This exploit is not going to be patched, as with all the other exploits. Nintendo is not going to patch these exploits because they don't support the Wii anymore. So this exploit's going to be here to stay, and it's going to be very, very nice, because basically that previous tutorial that I did, yeah, you can still follow that method, but this method's just way easier, and it's, you know, you don't have to have any sort of SD card or method of copying files over to your Wii. It's way easier, way simpler, as you guys saw in this video. So if this video helped you guys, definitely be sure to give it a thumbs up. Be sure to get subscribed down below and turn on channel notifications to get notified whenever that I upload a new video, which I do every single week on this channel. And also be sure to drop me a comment letting me know your guys' thoughts on this method. Are you excited about this? Are you going to try this because you could not get the previous two methods to work on your Wii? Be sure to let me know down in the comments, as I always enjoy reading what you guys have to say. And as always, I just want to thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.